all, I would like to introduce myself. My name is Sharifin Abdulali from Scan Associate Zelandra. I'm the managing consultant at Scan Associate. On my left is actually Saleh, my name is Saleh. We will present a paper. The title of the paper is The Silence of the Land. The flow of the presentation is I will do the presentation and I will switch off with Saleh to do some of the demo on the thing that we discovered earlier. So, as you may know, Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP is quite a common platform for any web-based application, either you use it for your forum, for your e-business application, and so on. So, the common mistake in PHP application that normally we found actually, we do a lot of penetration testing and source code auditing on application. So this is based on our experience while performing the test. And some of the bug that we found is not a new bug. It's being disclosed a lot by people like Sean Cole, RFP, and so on, and many people that if you know, like Frogman is using advisory on PHP almost every week in Bugtrap, if you are following Bugtrap. So this is the common problem that normally found in PHP application. Number one on the registered over, I will go on the details of the explanation later. App open function request. How you can upload your file in the application, external program administration, PHP and SQL injection. So this is some of the common problems that we found or discovered in PHP running on Linux using MySQL and Apache as the web server. Also, especially for this conference, we are announcing new bugs that we discovered yesterday in some quite popular PHP applications. Okay, I hope some of you guys are familiar with PHP, Apache, MySQL, and Linux. It doesn't really make sense. This is what we call a test on the web application. You might have firewall, but the test still can come through your port 80, because you're using Apache listening at port 80. So, most of the attack that we're going to show to you today will be can be an issue even though you are behind the firewall, or if you don't have any application firewall running on your server. Okay, the first problem that normally we found in the PHP the configuration in PHP II. In registered global variable, the default installation is off in PHP 4.1 and above, but the older version is on by default. But we find out that many PHP based applications still require this option to turn on because it's been written using the old PHP script. It's just to have some sort of backward compatibility on the system itself. This the track that can occur from this misconfiguration is basically any user can supply variable as local variable. I cookies, post data and query string. If you know the cookies, you can jump straight without any authentication, things like that. User can supply value to any unutilized variable. Okay, case study. This is quite an old module that we found in this dot project 0.2.1.5, where by inserting cookies directly to this application, you can bypass the authentication. It's very simple, and you can become the admin of the dot project without supplying any username or password. Just a very simple thing to do. And the reason is because if you look at the code under the permission of PHP, there is a if you see the empty user cookies, there is no implementation on that particular variable. So if you want to become the admin on the dot project on the dot project application, what you need to do is just put your user cookie as one, and you become admin on that particular application straight away. My colleague Sanek will do the demo on this particular exploit. It's quite an easy one to do.
Without any input validation. So that's the actual problem.
case study. For example, this is on the Shopbox version 2.32, where there is two problems actually. First, we can read any file with directory traversal. And actually, you can include the PHP script with Apache XSLog. Meaning you can type your netcat or you just send an IP and HTTP traffic with this system CMD as part of your traffic. And the system CMD here, the red one, system CMD will be appended with your XSLog. And only XSLog can be written by anybody because the function is for the Apache to log any of the traffic coming into the network. Combination with the directory traversal, basically we can send command with the function that already embedded in the XSLog. So despite any trick, when you cannot upload any file in the server, you can append PHP script in the XSLog and you can execute it if the PHP application is vulnerable to directory traversal. So we will show you the demo after this. The second version is actually the variable as prefix into the target itself. So you can have your remote include file. In this case, basically, you can run the command from the external system itself. So that's one of the problems that we found in Shopbox version 2.31 and version 2.32. So Saleh will show you some of the demo for this particular vulnerabilities. request in order resolution of this goal. So using the short form we can put it to the command of the government to you can see this application form and browse it in the initial form just put the link here implementation and then you already have a resident. So how to wait for it? You just we supply compressor to the specific script and we will put it into the PHP and that of the command. The second one is support 2.32. It has the same community but the author already fitted. They remove pollen from the supplier. So the technique is we can put our basic chicken facility as a stock. It's available to buy everybody. And then we buy the vehicle.
So that is actually the two
bug that we found in the Shopbox application. The next one, basically, you can, if you allow a user to upload the file, user to upload, use totally same file that has downloaded by user. Basically, you can upload any PHP script and use it to execute command and server. But nowadays, it's quite obsolete to find any application that allow you to upload similar file in terms of PHP script. The second one is actually use a partial file name supplied by user. And by using extension supplied by user with minimum error checking, for example, trust my type of file, you can embed some of the command in the file itself. For example, you can embed the command in this graphic. You can use text edit, some other text editor, and you can embed the system function in this image, and you can execute the command if they allow you to upload any file or any image in this file itself. So this is some of the example on how you can execute the command on the server itself once the image has been uploaded. Okay, we find a similar problem in this GitLog version 1.3.7 and below in May 2003, and I think Sunday is going to show you the demo on how this can be done today.
Yes.
लेकर PhD तो अपाची
variable category, you can SQL inject
inject the application to get the admin password of your PAP name. This only work on MySQL 4 because if I'm not mistaken, the previous MySQL did not allow the statement you need. So when you do this, basically you have the admin tag in base 64. You can decode it and supply the tag and become the admin of the PHP. So this is what we discovered yesterday, especially for this conference. But our advice is not really to defeat any attack. So, what if you do the demo on the new bugs that we discovered yesterday?
Thank you. Our fire. First, what you do is change our name with some sort of cash system. A system with a system CMD to run the command. In my opinion, we can use syntax selecting a file to say my spelling of the file. This is said to be a place that can be seen in more system to see any of spirit fire and electricity. Was there any limitation?
Web-based application is still relying on this
in the particular problems. During our exercise, during life test or course food, we find out there is a lot of environmental codes. The reason is a lot of programming will not filter the input. Meaning, once you have these variables, there is a lot of things that you can do. You can embed the command through SSLog, you can upload the file, GIF file, you can embed the PHP script on this image. You can create your own PHP script with this allowed list. And another problem that we see is that there is a lot of vulnerable in PHP application that haven't been disclosed yet. That's why we call this this presentation as Silent of the Lab, because there is a lot of people are hiding their PHP exploit or vulnerability. So we hope that you have seen some of these common problems and understand how many people may get into your system or have in your system. And this is all these common problems that have been disclosed since year 2001. If you guys have read the paper by Sherlock Holmes, director of the study in Scotland, he has disclosed a lot of ways on how you can bypass the PHP security and these problems still exist until now. With that, myself and Dale would like to thank the audience for the time, and we open the session for any questions. You can email us.